In this video, I am going to discuss about one more important strategy of designing the algorithm, that is dynamic programming. Like any other techniques like divide and conquer, transform and conquer, greedy technique, this is also one of the important algorithm design strategy. And in this video, I am going to discuss the difference between dynamic programming and greedy technique, and how we can solve the problems with dynamic programming, and the principle of optimality. It is this dynamic programming can be applied to a range of problems, particularly for optimization problems. So we can think of dynamic programming as a solution to the problem with a sequence of decisions. Sequence of using sequence of decisions, we can get the solution to the given problem. Say for example, the knapsack problem, what we have discussed in greedy technique. In this knapsack problem, whether some portion of the object x1 should be included into the knapsack or not, or should be filled with the knapsack with the x1 or not, that is one of the decisions we take. Then x2, then x3, and so on. Say if we consider shortest path problem, here again, if we are going to find the path from I to J vertex in a directed graph, then should we include the next intermediate vertex? Should we include the next intermediate vertex? Next intermediate, these are the sequence of decisions we need to take. But how this is different from greedy technique? In greedy technique also we take the decisions, but the sequence of decisions what we take in greedy technique are irrevocable. Once they are included, we cannot change it. But in case of dynamic programming, there may be multiple number of sequence of decisions, and one of the decision sequence may lead us the optimal solution. So greedy technique, dynamic programming can be thought of as to get the solution of the original problem by solving the sub problems with a sequence of decisions. And this sequence of decisions, if it is optimal, then it will lead us the solution of the given problem. This is the one way of thinking dynamic programming. The second way of thinking dynamic programming is, it is the solution of overlapping sub problems. If we find the solution of sub problems which are overlapping, then the sequence of those overlapping solutions will give us the solution to the original problem. Say for example, if I want to find Fibonacci series, say we know Fibonacci series, that is 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, and so on. Say if we want to find the nth Fibonacci number, then we need to find f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2. F of n minus 1 and f of n minus 2, if we find it, if we sum it, then we get the Fibonacci number of n Fibonacci number. Say if we go in the top down approach, say if I want to find f fifth Fibonacci number, then it is the sum of fourth Fibonacci series, fourth number and third number. Then this is third and 2. This is 2 and 1. This is 2 and 1. This is 1 and 0. This is 1 and 0. This is predefined. But we know that f of 0 is equal to 0, f of 1 is equal to 1. See that we are going to see this is calculated multiple number of times with a brute force approach, that is top down approach, and F of 1, that is this is calculated multiple number of times. So instead of calculating the solution of this sub problem, these are the sub problems for this original problem, calculating the solutions of the overlapping sub problems again and again, which consumes time and space, what dynamic programming will think of it? Memorizing those or tabulating those solutions of the sub problems and recording those solutions of the sub problem to get the solution of the original problem what we are having. Instead of doing this, say if we tabulate it, we know that f of 0 is 0, f of 1 is 1, and f of 2 is these 2, f of 3 is summation of these 2, f of 4 is summation of these 2, f of 5 is summation of these 2, that is this one. So this is how we have tabulated and we have recorded the solutions. Instead of calculating the solutions of the sub problems again and again, we have tabulated it. So tabulation and the memorization are the two techniques which are used in dynamic programming. That is, if the solution of the problem can be formed with the solutions of the sub problems which are overlapping, then we can tabulate them or we can memorize them so that we can use that for the finding solution. So how we are going to consume less time and less space is by tabulating it. That is principle of optimality. It says that if the sequence of decisions what you have made, whatever the initial condition or the initial decisions are, they will constitute the optimal solution. They will constitute the optimal solution. This is the fundamental difference between greedy technique and dynamic programming. In case of greedy technique, we are going to take the decisions, but those decisions are irrevocable. But in case of dynamic programming, we are going to take the sequence of decisions, but some of the decisions may not be used or may not constitute the solution to the original problem, but they will require less space and time because they are recorded either in the table or using memorization technique. Say for example, everyone of we have used log tables, right? Say when we want to solve some problem, logarithmic values are required. If those values we are going to calculate, lot of time will be consumed and lot of space will be consumed. Instead of that, we will have a logbook, we will refer it and we will solve it. So in this way, dynamic programming will help us to solve the problems by dynamic decisions intermediately taken while taking the sequence of decisions. Thank you.